Hello and welcome to this CorelDRAW Graphics Suite 2019 tutorial. This tutorial explores pixel-perfect workflows, not dissimilar to what you might find in Illustrator. We'll start by creating a new document and we'll head over to the web page options. Apart from the print options, you have a whole host of web page options. And from there, we'll just confirm our resolution at 96 dpi. And then what we're going to go ahead and do is open the color settings options and ensure that we are working at sRGB. Great, we'll hit the OK button on that. And then what we'll go ahead and do is drop down a page frame. So in Corel, that's pretty easy. Just double click the edge of the frame and hit the add page frame button. We'd like to get rid of the outline, so go ahead to your color palette on the far right, hit the right mouse button to get rid of that. Now on the color palettes, what we have is we have different types of color palettes, and here we're working with the RGB color palette, and that is accessed through the palettes docker. For now, let's disable the default color palette, and for Illustrator users, note that this is no different to swatches that you may find in Illustrator. I've gone ahead and chosen a color for the canvas. And of course, what we'll do next is we're going to head over to the Connect Content Docker. The Connect Content Docker is very similar to libraries, CC libraries in the Adobe world. And of course, what I'm going to go ahead and do here is I'm going to go ahead and choose a folder that exists on my computer. I'll go ahead and drag out this logo lockup. What we'd like to do is get rid of the background. So I'll head over to Objects, and you can see it's very visual. Pop down to the rectangle we don't want and simply hit the trash can. Next, what we'll do is we'll rename the layer so it makes more sense. And remember that that's searchable. So again, very similar to the layers panel that one might experience in the Illustrator world. We've made this a little larger. And then, of course, what we're going to do to show you what this align to pixel grid option does is we're going to disable snap to pixels for now. We'll make a few adjustments to kind of throw it off kilter so you can actually see what would happen if you weren't working with align to pixel grid, okay? Good. Notice that it's already in pixel mode because it's web-enabled workflow. And you'll see that it's vector and we'd expect it to be quite clean. Yet when we jump over the pixels, you'll notice it gets a little furry due to anti-aliasing. Now, anti-aliasing is good in most cases, but here, of course, we need it to be nice and clean. So let's head over to Snap to Pixels. That's just a reminder for future objects that we create. We're going to head over to the Align and Distribute option, hit Align with Pixel Grid, and it falls perfectly in place. Nice and clean looking output. So again, this is no different to the Illustrator experience where you would have gone and chosen this off your Properties panel. We're going to head over to the File menu and look at some of the export options. We have Export for Office, Web, and WordPress in the digital domain. And here we're going to choose Web, of course. Again, for Adobe users, you'll notice that this is very similar to tools like Save for Web and Export for Screens in Illustrator. So here we are. You can see we've got a whole host of different options in terms of formats, PNG, GIF, and JPEG. And of course, we can also predict how long it will take based on speed. Let's go ahead and zoom in to see what that looks like, because the proof of the pudding is in the tasting. I'll pick up the pan hand and just move around. And you can see we've got very clean looking output.